Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I said, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Tonight, everything is possible in Jesus' name.
Lálẹ́ yìí, ohun gbogbo ni ṣíṣe ní orúkọ Jésù.
You are going to close your eyes as we pray.
Ẹ ó díjú yín báyìí bá a ṣe fẹ́ gbàdúrà.
Even that day says your day.
Pẹ̀lú ìgbàgbọ́ pọ́jọ́ ti ẹ̀rẹ́
o. Your day of receiving your miracle.
Ọjọ́ gbígba ẹsẹ̀ ìyanu tìrẹ.
Almighty God, we thank you tonight.
Ọlọ́run Olódùmarè, a dúpẹ́ lọ́wọ́ yín lálẹ́ yìí.
We are grateful because you have called us here.
A fọ́re wa hàn pé ẹ pè wá wá sí yìí.
You have booked an appointment for every one of us here.
Ẹ̀yin lẹ ṣàdéhùn pẹ̀lú olúkúlùkù wa níhìn-ín.
And we know that tonight everything is possible for you.
Àwa sì mọ̀ gbangba pé pẹ̀lú yín lálẹ́ ohun gbogbo ni ṣíṣe.
We are praying that you come down in your mighty power.
A gbàdúrà pé kí ẹ sọ̀kalẹ̀ pẹ̀lú agbára ńlá yín.
And all your people that are here, men and women, boys and girls, you are going to bless everyone tremendously in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo àwọn ènìyàn yín ti ń bẹ ní ìlálẹ́ òní, takọ, tabo, tọmọdé, tàgbà. Ẹ ó bùkún fún wa ní ọ̀nà ìyanu ní orúkọ Jésù.
We pray that nobody will miss your hand of miracle tonight.
A gbàdúrà pé ọwọ́ ìyanu yín kò ní tà sí
ẹnikẹ́ni. You will break every yoke.
Ẹ ó já gbogbo àjàgà.
You will destroy the works of the devil.
Ẹ ó ba ẹsẹ̀ èṣù jẹ́.
You will heal the sick.
Ẹ ó wo aláìsàn sàn.
You will open the eyes of the blind.
Ẹ ó la ojú àwọn afọ́jú.
You will make the lame to walk.
Ẹ ó jẹ́ kárọ̀ ń rìn.
You will make the insanity to become
Gbogbo ẹni tó rí ẹ̀dàrú ni orí ẹ̀hún wà lẹ̀.
And you are going to bless everyone here.
Gbogbo wa lẹ́ òbùkún fún lálẹ́
yìí. Nobody will miss your miracle.
Kò sẹ́ni tí ó tà sí ẹsẹ̀ ìyanu
yìí. Do it for us in Jesus' name.
Ẹ ṣe fún wa ní orúkọ Jésù.
We thank you because we know you have answered.
A dúpẹ́ torí pé àmọ̀ pé ẹ ti dáhùn.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Ní orúkọ Jésù ni a gbàdúà.
Amen.
Àmì.
I bring a text to you from Isaiah chapter 45 verse 22.
Ẹsẹ̀ Bíbélì kan tí mo mú wá fún yín lálẹ́ yìí, òun ni Isaiah orí kẹrùndínní àádọ́ta ẹsẹ̀
kejìlélógójì. Isaiah 45 verse 22.
Isaiah orí kẹrùndínláàádọ́ta ẹsẹ̀
kejìlélógójì. You come to me and be saved. All the ends of the earth.
Wò kọjú sí mi kí a sì gbà yín là gbogbo òpin ayé.
The one talking is the Almighty.
Olódùmarè ló ń sọ̀rọ̀ ní.
The one talking is the one that never fails.
Ẹni tó sọ̀rọ̀ ní ilẹ̀ tí ìkùnà
láéláé. The one inviting you is the one that wants to bless you.
Ẹni tó ń pè ọ́ lẹ́ni tó fẹ́ bùkún fún ọ.
He is a God of all the earth.
Olóòní gbogbo ayé.
And he is a God of all flesh.
Olóòní Ọlọ́run gbogbo ẹran ara.
And with him all things are possible.
Pẹ̀lú rẹ̀ ohun gbogbo ni ṣíṣe.
And he calls upon you and he calls upon everyone.
Ó ń pè olúkúlùkù ènìyàn.
Look unto me.
Ó ní kọjú sí mi.
Then he says, and be ye saved.
Ó wá wí pé kí a sì gbà yín là.
In that word, be ye saved, there are many, many things there.
Nínú gbólóhùn kí a sì gbà yín là ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ nǹkan ló kọjọ́ bẹ̀.
There is a spiritual salvation.
Ìgbàlá tẹ̀mí wà bẹ̀.
There is a physical kind of salvation.
Ìgbàlá tara ń bẹ níbẹ̀ pẹ̀lú.
There is a kind of deliverance.
Ìdáǹdè kan wà níbẹ̀.
The hand of the Lord coming upon your life.
Kí ọwọ́ Ọlọ́run ó kayí ẹ.
And making sure that everything that is negative, the Lord destroys and demolishes everything.
Kí ó sì rí gbangba pé gbogbo ohun tó ń sọ wó òdì nínú ayé rẹ Ọlọ́run ó pa tun yóò sì parẹ́.
At the time you look unto him.
Ó ní ní gẹ́rẹ́ tó o bá kọjú sóhun.
That he will save you.
Kó ń ó gbà ọ́ là.
That he will heal you.
Kó ń ó wò ọ́ sàn.
That he will deliver you.
Kó ń ó da ọ́ nídè.
That he will set you free.
Kó ń ó sọ ẹ́dọ̀ mi nira.
That he will bring blessing upon your life.
Kó ń yóò mú ìbùkún wá nú ayé rẹ.
How many people can look upon the Lord for salvation, for healing, for deliverance?
Àwọn mẹ́lòó ló lè wo Ọlọ́run fún ìgbàlà, fún ìdáǹdè àti ìmúláradá.
All the ends of the earth.
Ó ní gbogbo òpin ayé.
That means no matter where you are coming from.
Ìyá ni pé ibikíbi tó wù kó ti máa wá.
No matter your condition, your situation.
Ipò kípò tó wù kó wà.
He says, look unto me and be ye saved. All the ends of the earth.
Ó ní kọjú sí mi kí a sì gbà yín là gbogbo òpin ayé.
You say what is there in a look.
Ó ní kí o wá bẹ̀rẹ̀ pé kí ló wà nù wíwo.
How you see it, I simply look at him and then all my problems are taken away.
Bó o lọ̀rọ̀ náà ṣe rí bẹ́ẹ̀ pé wíwo lásán gbogbo wàhálà mi ni yóò sì lọ.
When we talk about looking, there is a look of faith.
Nígbà tá a bá ń sọ nípa wíwo, wíwo ti ìgbàgbọ́ wà.
There is a look of trust.
Ìwíwo ti ìgbẹ́kẹ̀lé wà.
There is a look of love.
Wíwo ti ìfẹ́ wà pẹ̀lú.
And you know when people look at you, you see sometimes there is a look of confusion.
Nígbà táwọn èèyàn bá wo ọ báyìí, ìwo ìpòrúurú máa ń wà níbẹ̀.
But what the Lord is talking about is a look of faith.
Ṣùgbọ́n ohun tó ló wá ń sọ ni wíwo ti ìgbàgbọ́.
That if you can just see him by faith.
Tó o bá fojú ìgbàgbọ́ wò.
And see him as your creator.
Tó o wò bí ẹlẹ́dà rẹ.
And see him as your redeemer.
Tó o rí bí olùràpadà rẹ.
And see him as the restorer of all good things in your life.
Tó o rí gẹ́gẹ́ bí ẹni tí ó ń dá ohun rere padà sínú ayé rẹ.
And see him as your savior. I see him as your deliverer. The one that will take you away from the hand of the devil. The one that will uproot everything in your life that the heavenly father has not planted. The one that is going to give you a miracle. If you look on him tonight, you are going to be saved, you are going to be healed, you are going to be delivered in Jesus' name. Actually, there is a story in the Bible that shows that there is a healing in the look of faith. The story assures us, if you look at the Lord tonight, you'll be surprised. Before you leave here, you are going to have a miracle in Jesus' name. The story is told, the story is recorded in Numbers chapter 21. I'm reading to you from verse 4. And in those verses we are going to see, the people had suffering and sorrow. Eventually, because of their sin, sickness came upon their lives. But eventually, when they looked at the thing the Lord wanted them to look at, there was healing, there was salvation, there was deliverance for them. And very simply, those are the things we're talking about. Number one, the reasons for sorrow and suffering. In the world in which we live, why do we have so much suffering? So much sorrow, so much heartache, so much problem, so much heavy load, so much mountain upon us, so much confusion, so much conflict, so many things in our lives we cannot deal with. Number one, the reason for sorrow and for suffering. Number two is the remedy for sin and sickness. I have good news for you, that whatever sin may be in your life, there is a remedy for sin. And you find it at Calvary, with the Lord Jesus Christ. Because Jesus came into this world. In fact, the angels testify, we shall call his name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sin. There is a remedy for sin. And wonderful, there is a remedy for sickness. Whatever the sickness, call it cancer. Whatever the sickness, call it blindness. Whatever the sickness, call it paralysis. Whatever the sickness, call it insanity. Whatever the sickness, call it a yoke, call it a curse. Whatever the sickness, there is a remedy, and you are going to be healed tonight. In Jesus' name. And then number three, receiving salvation and healing. You will receive tonight. How many of you are going to receive something tonight? You will not go back home empty handed. You will receive in Jesus' name. But why do we suffer? Why are we sorrowful? What's the source of our problem? Numbers chapter 21 from verse 4. And the journey from Mount Ur by the way of the Red Sea to compass the land of Edom, and the soul of the people was much discouraged because of the way. The children of Israel, they want a journey. Actually, our lives are like a journey. And every birthday is like a milestone. It's like kilometer 1, kilometer 2, kilometer 50, kilometer 62. But as the people were journeying on and traveling on, Many problems came upon them. Because of that, there was discouragement. You know, in your own life, many things that have happened since year 1, since year 2, since year 40, since year 45. And because of all those things that came in our life, is it because of our family situation? Is it because of no job? Is it because of no rent? Is it because there's there's nothing I can use to eat?
Boya ko sinta
bi de. Is it because my children are suffering?
Boya tori pe omo mi
bi ya bi. Is it because I have enemies around me?
Tabi tori pe ota
yi meka. Is it because people are telling me move on and let us sell you will progress?
Tabi awon kan ton taka si mi pe
tesi wa yo ri bo se rin. Come sin lie.
Iporu ru tabi suru re wa tan.
Se
boya tori pe oti
mi yawo. Is it because you are married there's no chance?
Boya oni yawo o lomo.
In the kilometers of your life, in the milestones of your life, discouragement come.
Ninu awon igbese kokan ton gbe ninu irin ajo aye re.
And then in verse 5, and the people spake against God
and
against
Moses.
Moses, wherefore have ye brought us up out of Egypt, and have ye brought us up to die in this wilderness? For there is no bread, neither is there any water, and our soul loathed this light bread. You see the reason for the sorrow and the suffering.
Let me read
verse 6 before I comment on that. It says, and the Lord sent fiery serpents among the people, and they beat the people, and much people of Israel died. Story and the story of sorrow, the story of suffering. You know what happened to them? You know the way they began to use their tongues? They spoke against God. And they spoke against Moses.
Ben, Moses.
In your own life, maybe some things happen to you. What kind of God is this? Why am I living in this world like this? And then you speak against God. Not only that, you may speak against your own father that brought you into this world. Or against your mother that gave birth to you. Or it may be against the president of the country. Or it may be against the governor of the state. Against your landlord. Or it may be against somebody you think is the cause of your problem. What's the reason for our suffering? Our murmuring. Our grumbling. Our criticizing other people.
Or
it is a curse in our mouth. The little thing has happened to us. We put a curse upon people. Or it is evil speaking. We speak evil of our neighbor. Because we even blaspheme the name of God. You see the children of Israel, the little problem they had, they forgot to count their blessings one by one and see what the Lord has done for them. They forgot how the Lord brought them out of Egypt. They forgot how he parted the Red Sea. They forgot the goodness of the Lord. They forgot the manna they were eating every time. The free air you are breathing. You forget the free water you are drinking. You forget the life in you. You forget the sustenance of the Lord. You forget all the good things the Lord has done for you. You forget that there were people that were born at the time you were born. Now they are dead. Now they are buried. You are still alive. You forgot that many people are in the hospital. They hang their head. They hang their leg. They hang their hand. And you are still moving about freely. And so these people, they began to blaspheme the name of the Lord. They began to curse God. Maybe that is your problem. The problem of misusing your tongue. It may be that you slander people. It may be there is profanity in your mouth, cursing and swearing in your mouth. It may be lying and deception. Think about this now. There is no other sin that people commit their mouth will get involved. Have you seen somebody that has stolen? Have you stolen before? Your mouth will contribute to it. Do you commit adultery? Your mouth will contribute to it. Do you commit fornication? Your mouth will contribute to it. Do you fight? Your mouth will contribute to it. Whatever sin you commit, your mouth contributes to the sin. And actually that is the reason they were suffering. That's why the Bible says in Isaiah chapter 48, Isaiah 48 verse 22, it tells us the condition of the wicked. It says, there is no peace, says the Lord, unto the wicked.
Because
Thank God there is a remedy. Thank
God
there is deliverance. And the Lord will deliver you tonight in Jesus' name.
Wouldn't
it be a joyful thing? A happy thing? If all the sins you have committed, sins you are born into this world, God will just tell you, never mind, I forgive you. I forget everything. I will not record it against you anymore. I'm going to wipe everything away, blot everything away. That's exactly what he's going to do. That's why I come to point number two. Remedy for sin and sickness. Look at it in Numbers chapter 21. Therefore the people came to Moses and said, we have sinned, for we have spoken against the Lord and against thee. Pray unto the Lord that he take away the serpents from us. And Moses prayed for the people.
Nitori na awon eniyan na si to Mose wa won si wi pe awa ti se nitori ti awa ti ba Oluwa ati iwo so gbadura si Oluwa ki o mu ejo won yi kuro lodo wa Mose si gbadura fun awon eniyan na.
If you keep quiet, you'll be suffering in silence.
To ba panu ma e ba dake tare o ba dake.
If you keep quiet and you don't pray,
to ba dake to gbadura,
and you don't talk to God,
to bo Olorun soro,
and you don't ask us to pray for you,
to ni ka gbadura fun,
if you keep quiet,
to ba dake,
the problem there will remain.
Wahala na o wa nibe,
the mountain there will remain,
oke na o wa nibe,
the affliction there will remain,
ipaju na o wa nibe,
the yoke, the curse that the people of the world put upon you will remain.
Ajaga egun ta
file olori yo si wa nibe, but no, they will not remain.
Sugba won ni wa nbe mo,
I said they will not remain. You will be free tonight in Jesus name.
Wa do mi nira lale loruko
Jesus. See what they did.
So wa rin ti won se,
and the people,
awon eniyan na,
to Moses,
won to Moses wa,
not only one person,
ki se nikan,
not two, not three,
ki se meji meta,
the people,
awon eniyan na,
all the people that are suffering,
gbo awon to njiya,
all the people that are spoken wrong,
gbo awon to ti soro
lodi, all the people that the serpents were biting,
gbo awon tejo nbu sa,
all the people that ought to pray tonight,
awon
everybody, who are the people that ought to call on the name of the Lord tonight? Everyone, we're not talking about religion. Some people say, I'm only going there because I never go to church. I'm only going there. I don't believe in what they are saying. We're telling you that God is going to work a miracle in your life. I believe in miracle. I hope you believe in miracle. God will do something good in your life in Jesus' name.
Iyanu ninu aye re o gba ise iyanu gbo emi na gba ise iyanu gbo Oluwa yo se ninu aye re
dada. The people said, we have seen.
Awon eniyan na si wi pe awa ti se.
Wonderful. That's exactly what the Lord is expecting.
Iyanu lele un tolorun
reti re o. That's why the Bible says in Proverbs chapter 28.
Idi ni ti bibeli so so nu iwe owe ori keji ni
ogbon. Proverbs chapter 28 verse 13.
Iwe owe ori keji ni ogbon ese ketala.
He that covereth his sins shall not prosper.
O ni eni ti o ba bu ese re mole ki yo se rere.
I will prosper.
Emi o se rere o.
I will prosper.
Emi yo se rere.
I'm not talking about any other person. I will prosper.
Mo so nipa elomi o, alemi o se rere.
Prosper. I said you will prosper. If you want to prosper, the secret is you will not cover your sin. Because the Bible says, see that covereth the sin shall not prosper.
But whosoever
confesseth and forsaketh them.
Sugbon eni ti o je won ti o si ko won sile. Eni ti o ba je won ti o si ko won sile.
It is like when ants get into your dress, into your body.
Se bi o dabi igba ti era wonu ara re lo.
And all those ants, you are removing them.
Gbogbo awon ta ma ti yo wa mu kuro. O n ko won sile.
You are throwing them away.
O n ju won nu.
It is like when you get to your room.
Se bi o dabi igba to wonu le re.
All the ants are there.
To wa ri pa we re pa ra mole. Oni kile leyi.
And they get on the bed.
O wa won wa lori bed re.
And they get into the pot of soup.
Won wonu obe re.
And they get into the pot of water.
Won wa nu okolo ko to ti se
bi. In every corner.
No, go yara
you say, I will not sleep with this thing here tonight. All those ants, you take your broom, and you begin to sweep them away. If you have any fleas, you begin to flee them. You sweep them away. That's what you do to sin. You say, I will not sleep with the sin tonight. I will sweep them away with the broom of confession.
I'm
forsaking every sin. That's why the Bible says, he that confesses and forsaketh them. there
shall
mercy. What mercy is that? That's
the
mercy to pardon. That's
the
mercy to heal. That's the mercy to deliver. That's the mercy to set you free. The mercy of the Lord will come with the miracle of the Lord and get in your place tonight in Jesus' name.
In
Numbers chapter 21 verse
8,
after the people called unto the Lord through Moses,
and they called on
Moses, they said, you're looking at our condition,
don't
leave us like this.
We're
suffering, we're dying. See the sickness upon
us,
see the pain that came upon us. And then they said Moses should pray for them, and Moses prayed for them. And the Lord in verse 8 said unto Moses, make
thee
a fiery serpent and set it upon a pole, and it shall come to pass, everyone that is beaten, when he looketh upon it shall live. The Lord told them, he told Moses, he said the remedy is very simple. Everybody will be able to do it. Everybody will be able to get it. The miracle power of God comes to us in a very simple way.
If
the Lord has said anybody that goes to school, goes to university will be able to get it, many of us may not get it.
If
the Lord has said anybody that is able to speak a local language very well, deeply, is the only one that will get it. Some of us will not be able to get it. If the Lord
had
said those who have gone to church 7 times before today, those are the people that will get it. Many of us may not get it.
But
the Lord said only to look at that serpent of brass. Anyone that is able to look, he will live. Maybe you are saying, oh, if I'd been there, I would have looked at that serpent of brass. The sickness in my body would have vanished away. The
infirmity
in me would have gone away. The
paralysis
would have gone away. The blindness would have gone away. The tuberculosis would have gone away. Maybe you are saying, can somebody tell me where they put that serpent of brass? I will travel there, and I will go and look at it, and then I will have life. I bring good news to you tonight. Good news to you tonight. In John chapter 3 verse 14. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up.
Whosoever
believeth in him should not perish but have eternal life. Jesus Christ is greater than that serpent of brass. And Jesus Christ has been lifted upon the cross. He died on the cross of Calvary for you. And Almighty God has lifted him up like that, permitted him to die like that, so that all your sins can be forgiven, all your sicknesses can be taken away. That's the remedy that the Lord has given us. There's a Savior the Lord has given us. There's a healer, the great physician the Lord has given us. There's a deliverer the Lord has given us.
You'll
be delivered tonight. I said you'll be delivered tonight. That brings me to point number 3. Receiving salvation and healing. Receiving salvation and healing. How many of you are going to receive tonight?
The
miracle of God. The power of God. You will never be the same again in Jesus' name.
Receiving.
The Lord is giving it.
The
Lord is giving it. He'll give it to the man, give it to the woman. He'll give it to the boy, give it to the girl. He'll give it to the blind, give it to the lame. He'll give it to the insane. He'll give it to everyone. The Lord will bless everyone tonight in Jesus' name. And everybody say miracle. It's coming your way tonight in Jesus' name. That's my third point, receiving salvation and healing. In Numbers chapter 21 verse 9. And Moses made a serpent of brass, and he put it upon a pole, and it came to pass that if a serpent had beaten any man, notice that, any man, there is no discrimination in the house of God, any man, when he beheld the serpent of brass, he lived.
Moses si roi jo ideka, o si victory okpagun na, o si se, pe bi ejo kan to ba bu enikan ni ko si elede tabi eleyameya nbe ti o ba bu enikan san nigba ti o ba wo ejo na asiye.
That is the look of faith.
Iyan ni wiwo igbagbo.
As you look at Jesus tonight,
bi o se wo Jesus lale,
all your sins will be taken away.
A mo gogo ese
lo. As you look at Jesus tonight,
bi o se wo Jesus lale,
all your sicknesses will be taken away.
Gogo aro
ela mo lo. As you look at Jesus tonight,
bi o se wo Jesus lale,
your infirmity and insanity will be taken away.
Gogo okun re atori to daru la mo lo.
In John chapter 1 verse 29.
Idi ni to bi je pe Johanu ori kini ese ikokan lo gbo.
John sees Jesus coming unto him and he says, behold. He says, behold, if you want salvation, behold. If you want healing, behold. If you want deliverance, behold. Behold the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the world.
Ni jo keji Johanu ri Jesu nbo wa sodo re o si wi pe wo to ba fe gbala o lati wo to ba fe wo san o lati wo ni wo odun agutan Olorun eni ti o ku ese aye lo.
That's why we're told in Matthew chapter 8 verse 16.
Tori be la se so fun Matthew ori kejo ese
ikerin
nigbati o si di ojo asa
they brought unto him
many
that were possessed with devils.
Opo awon ti esun pa
loju and he cast out the spirits with his word.
O si fi oro oro le awon emi esun jade. O si mu gogo won larada.
He healed all.
O mu nu wa do wo gogo won larada.
He healed all.
Iyanu nla ni o wo gogo won larada.
He healed all.
Ese je iyanu nla wo gogo won sa.
He healed all.
O to fe padanu ni o wo gogo won sa.
Eyin
melo le ori ga.
Jesus is walking about.
Tori pe Jesu rin
kakiri. And it is free, you don't pay for it.
O ni sa wo fun
o. He wants to heal all.
O lo fe wo
won sa. He wants to heal you.
O fe wo esa.
He wants to open your blind eyes.
O fe la oju re to po.
He wants to take your problem away. He wants to drive the devil, those demons, out of your life.
Gogo esu ati emi re ni o le danu. O wo gogo won sa. Gogo awon to sa
esa. That it may be fulfilled. Which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet.
Ki ati so lati enu woli esa wa pe. Ohun ti kara re. Ohun ti kara re.
Took our infirmities.
Ba ailera wa.
Our sicknesses.
O si ru arun wa.
He has come to do it for you tonight.
O ti wa se fun lale
yo. He has come to bless you tonight.
O wa lati se fun lale.
You will never be the same in Jesus' name.
O si ni ri bakan na mo loruko Jesu.
Are you ready for the miracle of the Lord?
Se mura sile fun se yanu Olorun.
Are you ready for the touch of the Lord?
Se mura sile fun
ifowokan Olorun. Are you ready for your salvation?
Se mura sile fun igalayin.
All your sins to be forgiven.
Kadari gogo ese re
di o. All your sins to be forgiven.
Kadari gogo ese re di o.
Gogo n buburu to ti so. Everything you have done.
Gogo to ti se
to buru. For the Lord to take everything away.
Ki oluwa ko gogo re lo.
Ko wa wu e. It says you are not a sinner anymore.
Ko ni o se lese
mo. Remember anything you have done past. I've forgiven everything.
He wants to do it now.
He wants to do it now. Why don't you rise up and say, I will get it. And say, I will get it. I say, I will get it. Even if you have never come before, I will get it. This is my first time. I will get it. I've been coming before. I will get it. I've been doubting before. I will get it now. I will be forgiven. I will be forgiven. I will be forgiven. All my sins will be forgiven. Open your mouth. Talk to the Lord. Lord, forgive me.
Oluwa dariji mi.
He that confesseth and forsaketh a sin shall have mercy.
Eni to ba je wo to ko ese re sile yo ri anugba.
You don't pay money.
Oh, ni so
you don't do anything.
Oh, ni so
all the Lord is asking.
Gogo nto Olorun
bere. Just confess.
Iwo sa je wo.
Just forsake.
Ko sile.
And says that's all right.
A ni o ti yanju o. Mo ti dariji o.
I will never remember the sins against you anymore.
Mo ni rati ese na si omo. Je wo.
Just forsake.
Iwo sa ko sile.
And look unto Jesus Christ.
Ko wa wo Jesu
Christ. Your savior.
Olugbala
re. He died for you. To take your sins away.
Lati mu ese re lo.
Gbagbo. Believe and receive.
Gbagbo ko si
riga. Believe and receive.
Gbagbo ko si riga.
And receive it for the yours in Jesus' name.
Yours in the tyranny of God.
Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Confess your sins to the Lord.
Olua.
Say, Lord, I'm sorry.
Be Olua,
I'm a great sinner. I'm a bad person.
I've
said what I shouldn't have said. I'm careless in my life. I've done many bad things. But Lord, have mercy on me. Forgive me. Forgive me.
Forgive me.
I believe that Jesus died for me on the cross of Calvary. All my sins may be forgiven. In Jesus' name we pray.
Ni oruko Jesu ni agbadura.
Amen.
Amen.
You know, all those people, they came to Moses, they said, pray for us.
Gbogbo awon eyan yen lo to mese wa pe gbadura fun wa.
And if you want me to pray for you that all your sins should be forgiven.
Gbogbo ba fe kin gbadura fun ka dari gbogbo ese
re yo. If you want me to tell God that every sin you committed since you were born, you want him to forgive you, and I want to tell God on your behalf, you will raise up your hand and I will pray for God to forgive you.
To ba fe so pe e gbadura fun mi pe gbogbo ese ti mo ti da lati gba ti won ti bi mi, k'Olorun o le dariji mi ki o le mu ese na kuro, mo fe ko na owo re soke bayi.
If you are raising up your hand, you confess those sins to the Lord and you forsake them.
To ba na owo re soke ma je wo ese na fun Olorun.
Jesus, who are my savior.
Ko ni Jesus iwo lolugbala
mi. Jesus, who are my savior.
Jesus iwo lolugbala
mi. Jesus, who are my savior.
Jesus iwo lolugbala
mi. Jesus, who are my savior.
Jesus iwo lolugbala
mi. I am helpless, I am weak, I cannot overcome the sins myself. Jesus, come and save me.
Oje alailera alailagbara ko le gbara mi lowo ese Jesu wa ran mi lowo.
Amen.
Amen.
You believe in the mercy of God?
So gba nu Olorun gbo.
Tell me out loud, do you believe in the mercy of God?
E so kin gbo so gba nu Olorun gbo.
Then you will raise up your hand, keep up that hand.
Wa nawo re soke nawo yen dada.
That mercy will never fail on your behalf.
Anu yen o ni kuna nu aye.
Father, in the name of Jesus.
Baba ni oruko Jesu.
We know that you are a merciful God.
A mo so Olorun Alaanu ni.
Your seed server will confess and forsake will receive mercy.
Oni en to ba je to kan sile yo ri anuga.
It is your mercy that gives us salvation and forgiveness.
Anu re lo fun wa ni igbala ati
igariji. I pray for all these people who are sincere. I pray that your salvation will not miss them. Your forgiveness will not miss them. Your mercy will not elude them. Lord, in your mercy and forgiveness and love, forgive them in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, I pray for every one of them. Men and women, boys and girls. As many as are looking unto Jesus. Believing that he died for them on the cross of Calvary. That he died for them so they can be saved. So they can have eternal life. Lord, I pray in your love and mercy. Forgive them. Blot out their transgressions in Jesus' name. Confirm that salvation in their hearts right now. Confirm that forgiveness in their hearts right now. Thank you, Lord, because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
If you believe that, say loud, amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Okay, hallelujah.
Are you ready for your miracle? Are you ready for the healing? Are you ready for the deliverance? How many of you are going to get it tonight? You will look unto Jesus Christ. Your sickness will vanish away. Your infirmity will vanish away. Insanity will vanish away. Blindness will vanish away. Paralysis will vanish away. Tuberculosis will vanish away. Cancer will vanish away. You will get the miracle in Jesus' name. We're going to pray now. No matter who you are, whether you have come before, you have not come before, as you look unto Jesus now, that miracle power of the Lord will touch your body and you will get it. You will get it. Immediately we finish the prayer and you hear the amen of the people of God, you will open your eyes, you will check up yourself, you will see the miracle. And then whatever you were not able to do before, you will begin to do it. You will begin to do it. Tonight is miracle night. I want you to say, tonight is my miracle night. Tonight is my miracle night. Close your eyes. Let us pray.
You're...
You raise up one hand. You laid the other hand on the place where you have the problem. The miracle is coming your way right now. Almighty God, we thank you. We bless your name tonight. Already we know you are here. With your power. With your anointing. With the unction. The anointing that breaks the yoke is here tonight. I bring all the people before you tonight. Deliver them, heal them in Jesus' name. You devil and all your agents, all those demons and evil personalities, I command you, I take authority over you. I silence you and cast you out in Jesus' name. You pack your load from the bodies of the people, from the mind, from the brains of the people. Pack your load and go in Jesus' name.
Eni to ba di eru lo nru eru re mo pase pe eru to di satani keru re ko ma
lo lo ko Jesus. All the swelling in your body, all the hernia in your body, all the goiter in your body, all everything that is swollen, I command that swelling now come out in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo to wu lagwara yin boya gege ni tabi ipake onko to ba wu mo pase.
That sickness they call arthritis, that sickness they call rheumatism, high blood pressure, diabetes, I take authority over you. I command you, come out in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo aisan to ma nje aromalegun gbogbo aisan to nje ki suga po ninu agbara mo pase fun yin e jade loruko Jesu.
That cough with blood, that urine with blood, that venereal disease, that HIV and that evil sin in your body, I command now you cannot remain there. Come out in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo arun ka ma wu ko ka ma po eje ka ma to ka ma po eje gbogbo arun atosi gbogbo arun edi o ye ko wa nbe yen keru re ko jade loruko Jesu.
That ulcer, that cancer, that severe pain in the body, that thing like fire burning in the body, I command you, I take authority over you. You cannot hear the name of Jesus and remain. I command you, come out in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo agbe enu gbogbo aisan jarajegun gbogbo aisan ti o je ka gan aro lalafia ko ye ko wa nbe ye ta ba ti daruko Jesu tori na jade loruko Jesu.
That insanity in the brain, that madness in the brain, I command that evil personality, that spirit of epilepsy, I command you, I take authority over you. Come out in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo arun siwin gbogbo to n da opolo eyan ru gbogbo emi to nsise ninu opolo to nje ki wa rapo sele ko ye ke wa nbe o e jade loruko Jesu.
All the mysterious attacks, the mysterious afflictions that came from powers of darkness, that came from any yoke, from any curse, from all the evil powers, I take authority over you and I command you, come out in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo ofa ota to fa jaga ele to ti odo ta wa ibi te wa yen ko nile yin tori be mo pase fun yin gbogbo ajaja ati ofa ota e jade loruko Jesu.
Barrenness in the family, I take authority over you. Lack of progress of those people, I take authority over you. I pray, Lord, you give them their miracle babies. By this time next year, they'll be able to testify with their babies in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo iyagan ninu ebi yin gbogbo ka ma sise erin ka ma jije liri to wa ninu ebi yin mo pase pe emi iyagan yo jade to be niwo yi amodun omo se iyanu e gbejo loruko Jesu.
I pray for those who are blind.
Mo gbadura fun awon to foju.
That bandage of the devil, that cataract, that blindness, I command you, get out now. You blind eyes, be opened and begin to see in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo igbaja satani ati ipepe satani to nbe ninu oju mo pase pe ti satani ni ko jade ki oju to fo yen ko riran ni oruko Jesu.
Those who are deaf and dumb, I pray that the Lord will touch your ears, will touch your throat, will touch your vocal cords, be opened, begin to hear, begin to speak in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo eti to di ati ahan ti o le soro mo wa pase bayi wi pe awon Olorun yo kan han yin.
All those paralyzed legs and strokes and withered hands, I command right now that vitality and power will enter into your body, into your joint, into your bone. Rise up and walk in Jesus' name.
Ati awon ti ara won ro ti o je aro mo wa pase iye sinu egungun yin sinu isese yin ni bayi e dide e ma ri ni oruko Jesus.
Lord, I bring everybody on before you.
Oluwa gbogbo
to be la towa okunrin
obirin
omo de ada, whatever healing, whatever deliverance, whatever miracle they need,
ise yaru ti o
ra fe, let your hand of miracle touch everyone right now in Jesus' name.
E je ki owo ise yanu yin o ba won bayi ni oruko Jesus.
Receive your healing,
egba iwo sayin,
receive your deliverance, receive your miracle,
egba ise yanu yin.
Oh Lord, confirm it on this field everywhere right now in Jesus' name.
Oluwa fi idi eyi mule ni gbogbo ori papa yi ni oruko Jesu.
Thank you Lord, because I know you have answered.
Oluwa mo dupe
so ni
mo
ma
fe ti down, mo ma fe ti down.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Ni oruko Jesu ni agbadua.
Amen.
Amen.
I have got it.
Mo ti ri gba.
I have got it.
Emi ti ri gba.
I have got it.
Mo ti ri gba.
The miracle is right there with you.
Ise iyanu yen ti wa.